Hello students of 10th standard. Today we are going to start the lesson that is nothing but lesson number 2 from section B that is nothing but life processes in living organism. Before going to this lesson, we have to understand what are living organisms. Living organisms are the organisms which have life in them or which show various processes. These processes are nothing but growth, reproduction, then again respiration, then again excretion, digestion, then various processes like you can say stimulus. These all processes are shown by the living organisms. Now, what do you mean by, you can say, life processes? Life processes are nothing but you can say processes, whichever are used to lead the life. That are nothing but digestion, you can say excretion, circulation, reproduction, then again respiration. Various types of the processes are there which are used for our life processes. Now, in this lesson, what we are going to see? We are going to see the life processes whichever are used for or whichever are useful for us, or you can say the cell, energy of a cell, or you can say the cell division. These are the components that we are going to see in this lesson. Then, first, what we have to see? The life processes means what? The most of the important process is nothing but the digestion. So, what does this digestion tells us? Digestion is nothing but a process in which the complex food materials are broken down into a simpler form. This is nothing but the digestion with the help of the enzymes. This process is done with the help of the enzymes. So that is nothing but a digestion. Now, in digestion what happens? First, we are going to take the food from our mouth. Then we are going to chew it with the help of the, you can say, teeth. Then we are going to mix it with saliva. Then this bolus, this, you can say, food material is called as a bolus. Then it goes into the esophagus. Then from esophagus, it goes into the stomach. Then from stomach, it goes into the intestine. Then from intestine, it goes to the anus. So this way, there is a process of a digestion. Now, in this digestion, various types of, a, you can say, processes takes place, or you can say various enzymes helps there, various digestive juices helps there. There are again, you can say, associated glands like liver, pancreas, digestive glands are there which helps in these processes. Now, also in digestive, you can say, process, then again the respiration process is also most important. In respiration process, what we are doing? We are inhaling the air, we are absorbing the oxygen, and we are sending the carbon dioxide outside. This is nothing but a, you can say, respiration. Or in other words, the inhaling, or you can say exhaling of the air is nothing but a respiration. These two processes are interrelated in between them. So what is that we are going to see in detail? The first question is, how are the foodstuffs and their nutrient contents useful for our body? So what I have told you, in digestion what we are doing? We are converting the complex food material into simpler form with the help of the enzymes. This I have told you. Now here, the complex food material is nothing but a food whichever we are taking in, or the nutrients whichever we are taking inside our body. So what is the question here? How are the foodstuffs? Foodstuffs means whichever we are taking, the nutrients whichever we are taking inside. Or their nutrient content. So what is contained in them that is useful for our body? How it is useful for our body, that we are going to see. See here, the foodstuffs are digested and converted into soluble nutrients. So the foodstuffs whichever we are eating, that are nothing but the nutrients whichever we are eating, or the food whichever we are eating whenever we are taking our meals. So what does it tells? It is converted into soluble form. Why it is converted into soluble form? Because the complex food material is not readily digested in our body. So it is converted into, you can say, soluble form, and then it is used by each and every cell of the body. Now see here, these nutrients are carried by blood to every cell of the body. Now what happens actually there? We eat the nutrients from our mouth, but they should be reached to each and every point of the body. So there should be one, you can say, medium, and that medium is nothing but a connective tissue which is called as a blood. So the blood takes these nutrients from one place to the another. So whenever it is taking this from one place to the another, each and every cell of the body gets the energy. Then see here, the oxygen inhaled at the time of respiration is also carried to every cell. Not only these nutrients are carried to each and every cell, but whatever the air we respire, that is also carried to each and every cell of the body. In the body, the cells, this oxygen carries out oxidation. So what happens actually, see here, whenever there is a, you can say, each and every cell gets the nutrients, or you can say the oxygen, then what happens? There is a oxidation of these nutrients. And what happens whenever there is a oxidation of the nutrients? There will be production of the energy. The energy helps the body to carry out all the functions. So there are various functions in the body that are running, that are nothing but running, walking, talking, writing, doing various again works. Then there are again life processes which are carried out in the body. So all these are carried out whenever there is a help of a energy. That means here energy is needed for the functioning of each and every part of the body. The nutrient help in the growth of the development of the body. So what it is done, see, whatever nutrients we are eating, they are helping the body. How they are helping the body? They are helping the body in the form of the of their growth, or you can say in the development. What is importance of the balanced diet for the body? Now whatever the nutrients we are taking, they are in the form of a balanced diet. So balanced diet means actually what here? So balanced diet means whatever diet we are taking during our every meal, that is nothing but a balanced diet. That means it contains the proper amount of a carbohydrate, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals. But how are they? They are in a right proportion. Each nutrient carries a specific important function. Each nutrient, whichever is present, carries the specific function, or it has the important function. Now see here, in balanced diet, all nutrients are in a right proportion. So if you take the all the, you can say, nutrients in a right proportion, then and then only you can get a balanced diet. Now, since balanced diet is required for energy and nutrition, it is very important to maintain our health. Now, what in balanced diet we are going to take? In balanced diet, we are going to take bhakri or chapati, then again rice, then vegetables, then curd or various, you can say, buttermilk, salad, all these things we are taking. So how these all things are made? These are made in by constituting all in the all materials in a right proportion. So what does the carbohydrates gives us? Carbohydrates gives us energy. Then again proteins, they are used as the body building. Then vitamins and minerals, they are used as a to do the vital, you can say, activities in the body. Then again fats, they are also giving us energy. So all these things, if you take a right proportion, then and then it will be only the balanced diet. And if you take the balanced diet in and right proportion, then and then only it will give you the energy which is needed for your body in a right proportion.